When it's not always raining, there'll be days like this. When there's no one.
Morning, everyone. Welcome to my studio once again. Well, we're in sort of a lockdown with this horrid coronavirus. So I thought I would start doing some videos so that you can do some great projects at home to spread the boredom around. What I'm going to do today, with Easter coming up, I thought it would be nice to do a little gift that you could do for someone. This one I've done with Ferrero Rocher's only because I didn't have Easter eggs in the cupboard, but fill them with Easter eggs, give them to kids, to parents, to your friends if you're allowed to see them, but you could give them at maybe 2 meter distance, so you could put them on a shovel or something and give it to them, I don't know, but maybe wipe it over before you give it to them. So we're going to do this today. That's just a little purple one I've done. This is a male one I've done, a little bit different. I've put a little pattern around that, and I'll show you how to do that today. It's very optional. Now, don't think that you have to have some great tools or anything to do this, because I'm going to give you some simple options that you can do with anything that you've got around the house. So I'm going to do, as you can see, a bright yellow one today. This is all used in Stampin' Up! Products. If you're out of your supplies, don't forget to go online. You can order any of your supplies on my online shop. That's still open. Otherwise, you can just use what you've got around the house. Now, if you're stuck at home with kids, go through your cupboards, and if you've kept some of your old greeting cards, you could cut them up for your decorative pieces for around the side. You could just use any colour cardstock you have. Also, if you haven't got any DSP, you could get the kids to do some painting on some paper and then cut it up to size for the decorative pieces. Now, all the measurements and everything I'm going to give you today will be on my blog site. And also, if you would like an instruction sheet, please feel free to email me or text me, message me, whatever, and I can email one to you without a problem. I've got it all done from when I used to make them a couple of years ago, but I just thought these were a nice little project to do while we're all stuck at home. So let's get started. I'm going to use my Simply Score board. Now, a piece of cardstock is cut to 9.5 inches by 7¾ inches. That's 24.1 centimetres by 19.7 centimetres. Now, all the measurements I've done today are inches, but where possible, I'll give you the approximate centimetres. So it's up to you what you want to use. The school board can come with a centimetre conversion, but the instructions I was originally given was given in inches, so that's what I'm going with. So you cut your cardstock, to 9.5 by 7¾ inches, okay? On the long side, that's the long side at the top, we're going to put that there. We're going to get our scoring tool. I'll use the smaller end of the scoring tool. If you don't have a scoreboard, take a ruler and a pencil. It's going to take a little bit longer, but you can do your measurements along the top and the bottom, and then take your ruler and something that's got a blunt edge that you can score your lines down like that. Doesn't have to be on a scoreboard like this, okay? So as long as you've got a ruler and something to do your score lines with, you'll be right. Okay, so scoring tool. Okay, first score line with the long side at the top is going to be 1.5 inches, and that's about 3.8 centimeters. So we're going to do a score line there. Second one is at 3 inches, which is 7.6 centimeters. We're going to go 4.5. So as you will see, it's about 1.5 inches all along. 4.5, which is 11.4 centimetres. Then we go 6 inches, 7.5 inches, and 9 inches. Okay, so you can see the the score lines on the cardstock. We're just going to turn that, doesn't matter which way you turn it. We're going to do on the short side now, with the short side at the top of your scoreboard, or if you're using your ruler, just to turn it round and do your measurements top and bottom on the short sides. Okay, so the short side, we're just going to do two score lines, one at 1.5, which is 3.8 centimetres, and 5.25 inches. Okay, and so there we have the score lines. I don't know whether you can see that in the light, but as you do it, you'll see it. Okay, that's all the scoring we're going to do for now. So what I like to do now is, as you will see, where we scored at the 9 inches, we've just got these three smaller rectangle pieces. The two smaller ones on each end, we're not going to use. So we're going to cut them off. But when we do it, this long middle one we are going to keep. So we just want to do a small wedge. So we're just going to triangle that into the corner, and we're going to cut that up. Okay, not quite. Okay, you can see what I mean by the wedge. Okay, and we're going to do that the same on this small rectangle. We're going to do the angle the other way to the corner and then cut up. Now, I must say I can't take credit for the design for this. I first saw it on a lady who is in the UK, the lovely Linda Parker, who was a demonstrator for Stampin' Up, but no longer is. She's moved on, but she has some great videos on her YouTube, and that's where I saw this, and I thought, I'd like to show my Australian ladies that. Okay, so this is what your cardstock should look like, looking nice and bright. So it's at this stage, or before I go, if you wanted to do this decorative pattern here, see with the holes in it, does look quite nice. I have used the envelope punch board to do that. Okay, so it's probably at this stage where you would do these holes. Now, I'm not going to actually do it on this one. Oh, what the heck, I will. So you would need to burnish all your sides with, we'll just do this one for now. Burnish them all with your bone folder. Okay, gives it that nice crisp fold. Now, if you're going to do projects, making these nice crisp folds is very important for accuracy in that. So it just makes it easier to do that. And then this little one as well. Okay, so the long side here is going to get folded down. This is the base, the shorter ones. So what we need to do is, if you're going to do these decorative pieces, you're going to fold the short pieces down, line up the crease, and in the middle of your punch there, punch it down. Now you might need to stand up to do that, and see, that creates your nice little hole. So go along and do that. As I said, this is an optional lecture. You do not need to do this. If you don't want to, it looks perfectly fine without them. Oh, just a bit of muscle there. Okay, I'll put those aside for the rubbish. Okay, so we've burnished the sides, we've done our pattern pieces. Now we're going to glue down some of our pieces. So if you didn't have the decorative side, you could place these in the middle. But because we've got the decorative holes in it, we're going to place these up towards the top more. So I'm going to use my brand new, because I was running out of liquid glue, our Tombow. And now this, just remember, this is the base. So you want your pattern, if you do have a pattern, to go up the right way. These are balloons and that. So
If I wanted to, I could do that, but I'm going to do the balloons. So we're going to just glue these down. Talk among yourselves while we do this. I hope everyone's coping with all these restrictions put on. But hey, we'll all get through this and we'll all come out the other side stronger and better than ever. And craftier, hopefully. Well, all my videos I've got planned. There's some fun things coming up. But also just to let you know that Stampin' Up! Is still going strong and we still have some fantastic products available and you just might need some. Also, if you send me a picture of your, if you live in Australia and you're watching this video, if you send me a picture of anything, of any, if you've made this, or if you put in a suggestion of what you would like me to do on a video, you will automatically go into a drawer, which will be drawn the end of March, coming up very soon, 31st of March, to win a card kit and some other goodies worth over $50. So all you've got to do is get in contact with me, place an order, send me an email, I don't care. If I hear from you in any way, I will enter you into the draw. And I'll do a live draw on a live Facebook, I think. I've just made that executive decision. God, I'm good. Executive decisions. I didn't even have to consult my committee. What committee, she says? It's me. Okay, last one. Okay, so we've got those pieces glued on. Just on that, you don't have to do them like this. I could have done alternative patterns because this pattern, all our DSP are double-sided. So I could have done alternate ones there. So what we're going to do now is put it all together. So first of all, so we've cut our strips. We're going to glue this one. We're going to put a strip along here of our double-sided tape. Now I like to use double-sided tape. This is really strong, so for projects like this, double-sided tape is good. Your liquid glue, your Tombow, is also very good. I wouldn't use your snail for any projects like this. I just don't think it's strong enough. If you had the old Fast and Fuse, yes, but not your your snail. Okay, so what we're going to do here is we're going to put a strip of glue along here, but we're not going to do it all the way because this is actually going to fold into there. So we need to have a space here because this will fold down. You'll see as we go along anyway. So just make sure that on this side where there's no tab, leave a bit of a gap. Okay, just so that we can tuck that bit in. Now, if you wanted to do two strips, that's fine, but I find one is enough. You could do another one down here. But yeah, as I said, I find that's enough. So make sure you press your double-sided tape down really well. Get my fingers and nails working. Okay, so we're going to fold that down. Press it really hard. Okay. What I like to do at this stage is just go along and reinforce those folds. So we're going to take the double-sided tape now off the tab. Fingernails again, they're good. Okay, so then we're going to slip that in there and line that up and press. So there, you can hardly even see the seam. Okay, easy as. So we've got something that looks like this. Okay, at this stage, you can put something in there to hold it all together, like a ball of string or anything that fits in there just to hold it in place. But I'm not going to worry about that today. So what we're going to do, I'm going to take my liquid glue for this, and we're going to fold these over one by one. You can do, look, do you know what, there was advice given to me when I first did this, but I just find, you know, everyone I make is different. So you can do alternate. I find I do the one next to it, and I keep overlapping them like that. A little bit of glue. Just make sure you keep your shape. And I'll show you a little trick in a minute to stick it all down. Don't press really hard. You don't have to press really hard at this stage. So then you just, yeah, it doesn't look, I know, it doesn't look the best. Excuse me, is my head in the way? But then if you turn it up like that, get your shape, get your bone fold or rule or whatever, and just give it a press like that until that glue all takes. You can see there. Okay. There you've got your basic cup. Great coffee cup. I wouldn't put real coffee in it, mind you. I've got my coffee here. Yeah. So that's that. What I have done is I've taken my was it the 2 1/4 punch, I think I did, or anything. It wasn't quite, see it doesn't quite there make it, it's not quite, but I just put, that was the largest one I had. So just to put around the bottom, it just reinforces it, and it just tidies up that, those fold over bits, okay? So that's that. And then all we've got to do is the handle. So when I cut my cardstock, I had a strip this big, which is just perfect. But it measures, it should measure 1/2 inch by 6 inches. And of course this was longer, so I'm just going to trim this down. This doesn't have to be exact because it's only the handle, okay? So a little trick is when you've got your strip, just stretch it a bit, stretch those paper fibers out like that, so it curves a bit. So you just, you know what you do with your ribbon, you know, your present ribbon to make ribbon curls. Okay, so I'm going to find my seam, which is there, and I'm just going to work out where I want my handle, which is there. So you glue, I'll show you how to do this, glue a little bit of glue on one end, so that goes up like that. Okay, hold it in place till that liquid glue takes. Okay, and I would use your liquid glue for this, and then that one down like that, if you can see. Okay, so just a little bit of glue on that, and then I just line it up with the end of your designer series paper. There's your handle. And there's your coffee mug. Now, I think these are a great little gift idea. As I said, this was the one I made in the purple. I'm not going to decorate this one too much more because the paper is very busy. But you can see you can do them for any occasion, and for males, you can do them for birthdays. But with Easter coming up, it's a great, oh, my handle's come undone. I didn't hold it long enough. But so that's your coffee mug. Okay, so that's all I've got time for today. Hope you like the video. Please subscribe to my channel. Don't forget, enter the competition by either ordering something online through my online shop if you're in Australia, by the end of March, and that will, if you spend over $90, that will qualify you for a free gift through Celebration. Or email me, let me know, leave a message, any name that appears on this video, any comments or anything, you will go into the draw, and I'll just get the prize. Bear with me. This is the prize I've got so far. No, it's not just the paper bag. It is a card kit, which is the kerchief one, which is no longer available because they're out of stock. And it's also the Thoughtful Blooms stamp set. And I will throw in a glue. I will throw in a Tombow as well. And they're just some little butterflies that I've made. If you'd like to know how to make the little butterflies, message me. You'll be in the draw. So I'm going to draw this on the 31st of March. I was going to do it in April, but I think I'll bring it forward because I've cancelled all my classes. And whoever wins this may need this in these troubling times. So got to be in it to win it. Thanks for joining me today, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.
When there's not a-